Story 48. Thomas Riner. Virginia. Fancy Hill Farm. Owner. Farming. When I was 21 years old, I started working at a very large manufacturing plant that did high-consequence precision manufacturing work. After 8 years of moving into different positions, I took a job with the Process Improvement Group. Starting in the group, we went through 5 weeks of intense training on Lean Six Sigma. Following 3 years of training and working projects, I was certified as a Lean Six Sigma Master Black Belt. I was trained in Six Sigma, Lean Manufacturing, Design for Six Sigma, Hoshin Planning, Theory of Constraints, and Vulnerability Assessment. Over the 8 years, I was in the group I worked transactionally, quality, span, design, and modeling projects. I worked in numerous states, at sister plants, traveled to naval bases, government laboratories, nuclear power plants, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission headquarters near Washington, D.C., and multiple Department of Energy sites. I worked with high-consequence security groups, human resources, IT, operations, engineering, safety, and quality control. From a process improvement perspective, I was what most people would consider an expert. Little did I know that with all the training and experience I acquired, I completely missed it. I had missed something so elegant and simple that it would eventually change every aspect of my life. What surprises me, to this day, is that it would take farming to help me understand how I misunderstood lean. My wife Jenny and I have been happily married for over 20 years. When we were dating, we loved farms and would ride around looking at them. We both dreamed of owning a farm of our own. After 15 years of marriage, we purchased the property that would become Fancy Hill Farm. Once we moved to the farm, we started raising livestock to be more self-reliant. After a short time, people started asking if they could buy our eggs and the meat we had raised. We had so many people making requests that Jenny and I decided to start selling livestock and meat. What started with 3 or 4 chickens and 1 pig rapidly grew. In a short period of time, we had 100 chickens, multiple cows, and 40 hogs. We had one of the largest hog farms in the county where we lived. Jenny and I had all the problems of growing a small business and the normal problems that farmers face every day. I was working a full-time job, and Jenny had 2 active teens in the house that she was homeschooling. Cash flow problems were an issue, along with long lead times for the products we were selling. Over time, Jenny and I became overwhelmed, and we couldn't keep up with all the changes on the farm. The farm had reached a breaking point, and we both began to talk about giving up on farming. Jenny and I knew we would hate to do that, but we couldn't see any way through the enormity of what the farm had become. With all my business experience and process improvement knowledge, I couldn't figure out what to do. We needed a solution, and I was frustrated that I didn't have one. That is when a coworker introduced me to 2-Second Lean. I read the book and began watching Paul Akers' videos. While I had a head knowledge of everything that Paul covered in his book, I was supposed to be an expert, I'd never really grasped lean. Over time, I would eventually watch every video that Paul Akers made, literally. With each small improvement video, I began to see the power of making a small improvement every day. Through the videos, I began to truly understand the power of lean. When I started to fix what bugged me in my own life, I started to see waste. Once you start to see waste, you can never unsee it. That waste will drive you crazy, and you will do everything in your power to eliminate that waste. Eventually, I reached out to Paul and he began to mentor me. I was able to visit FastCap at one of the first global lean leadership summits. Eventually, I traveled to Japan with Paul, where I went on a life-changing lean study mission. Along the way, people began calling me the Lean Farmer. I started the YouTube channel called The Lean Farmer. With every improvement video I made, my knowledge of lean grew. There is something powerful about making a video where you show the waste and then show the improvement. Our farm life was and still is challenging, but 2-Second Lean changed everything. We began to see waste on the farm, and even though things were crazy busy, we started making small improvements. Those small improvements saved our dream of having a farm. As time passed, I began applying 2-Second Lean to my health and what I ate. Even when we traveled, we made small improvements to everything we did. I eventually began applying 2-Second Lean to all aspects of my life, including what I read, my thoughts, my goals, and how I wanted to live my life. 2-Second Lean changed everything about my life. Each day I got to relish in the improvements I had made. Doing push-ups as soon as my feet hit the floor in the morning. Pulling my toothbrush out of my Kaizen foam. What I eat in my lunch, and even how I pack my lunch, are just some of my improvements. Throughout the workday, I'm surrounded by small improvements. When I get home to work on the farm, I see improvements with how we store grain, how we get grain, the order in which we feed and water animals. With all the training and knowledge that I had been given in the process of continuous improvement, I completely missed the beauty and simplicity that is lean. Like most people, I tried to overcomplicate lean. I'm so thankful that it took a farm that was falling apart to, quote, flip my lean switch. This helped me see all the waste in my life and how much potential for improvement existed. Lean is not a tool. It is not a methodology. It is a way of living your life to its fullest potential.